Welcome back to Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. We've defeated the two gods stopping us from going over this bridge over the River of Knives. Let's cross it. Oh, we got a shield one.
Every gate you open into darkness brings another challenge.
Ooh, is this a boss? Oh yeah, that's a boss. Did I just die? Shit. Alright, I don't think I can block those attacks. Oh, damn it! Alright, I'm gonna try to regain my health, just back up. Okay, here we go. Damn it. Oh, crap! Sounds like there's someone behind me.
It's nearly over. Finish
it. Oh, there's... Yeah, okay. I see him. Another one over there. I thought that was the boss still, but no. Thankfully, it's not.
Remember the warrior trials.
Got a shield guy on the left. Took him out. Wait, that's it? Because I didn't kill the boss. I guess it's gonna come back later, huh? Well, let's admire the scenery. I can still just barely see the snowy mountain peaks. Rough seas. The ship dashed upon the rocks. I love this game. Just visually, if nothing else. I mean, I like other stuff about it, but like, especially visually, it's gorgeous.
However you come to the gold-covered bridge that leads to Hell, you may find it guarded by a giantess. She will ask your name. She will ask your lineage. She will ask your business. The Northmen tell of the warrior woman Brynhild, who leapt into fire and rode to Hell to join her slain love Sigurd, and is challenged by the giantess.
The journey to Helheim is never a straight one. Each must find their own path. Align yourself to its secrets, and you will find yours.
It's so cool that we actually get to go on the boat. What am I seeing there? I can't tell if that's just a very strange looking thing on purpose or a rendering error. It's like little shards of an environment. Of like stairs. Why is everything all blue? Oh, that was definitely on purpose. I just made that bridge real. But yeah, why is everything all blue? Am I getting cold? Let's see if it goes away when I go back indoors. Yeah, it's gone now. Or, no, it's still there. Got one of them. I just need to look at it the right way to see an X now. There's a ladder down there, down that way, but what's over here? Ah.
Oh, Senua. Your father does not hate me. He just fears the souls in the underworld. He cannot see that they are already afraid. But I am their healer, and I must answer their cries for help, even if it displeases him.
Let's see what's down here now.
Hela possesses large dwelling places in Helheim. Tall are her walls, high are her gates. The name of her dish is hunger. Her knife is famine. On her threshold, all will stumble. Her bed is called sick bed, and her bed hangings are called flames of a funeral pyre. They say she is easy to recognize, half black and half the color of flesh, and her face menacing and grim.
Aha.
Song again.
Is it?
It's Hela.
Yes. the source of the darkness. It's coming. This is your moment.
Oh my God.
I'm sorry.
What are you doing? You're showing weakness. You're not a warrior. You're a disgrace. The gods will punish you for this. Pick up the sword. Pick it up. Fight the darkness. Fight it. Get up. Get up. Get up and fight!
Stormy seas and lost souls. She's dreamt of this before. They say dreams are visions of our memories, thoughts, and fears, as seen by our inner eye. But what if each one of us is always dreaming, even when awake, and we only see what our inner eye creates for us? Is this what hell is? A world shaped by Senua's nightmares? Maybe that's why people feared seeing the world through her eyes. Because if you believe that Senua's reality is twisted, you must accept that yours might be too.
You failed the gods. You're pathetic. Rotten. Cursed. What were you thinking? Did you really think you could win? How stupid can you be?
So stupid.
Everyone hates her. She's a curse.
The shadow hates.
Look at you. A warrior. Worthless. Weak. Pathetic. Go on. Feel sorry for yourself, because there's no one left to do that for you.
Everywhere.
You failed. What's that?
Take it. If you're too much of a coward to fight, then end the suffering. Broken and lost. Just
do
like
it,
your sword.
Do it. Come on. Dare.
Why go on? When you give everything and face that which torments you, only to find that it is worse than you could have imagined. Why go on? Is it really so weak to ask this? Or are we just so afraid of the honest answer that we do not dare pose the question? Sometimes the answer lies in a memory, a feeling. A song.
It's real. It's true. It's real. Listen to it.
She don't give up.
Did it?
Not like this.
It's not real. It's real. It's a trick. Don't trust it. Maybe you're already dead.
Who are you?
Do you still believe in me, Sarah?
It's real. It's happening. Go towards it.
feel like I'm definitely supposed to go to him. I mean, obviously I am, but I'm also curious. What's over here? Ah, look at those mountain peaks. It's weird to be admiring how gorgeous the scenery is at such a time like this. Kasenawa is doing particularly bad right now.
When she first met him, she was not in a good place. Just a teenager, but not like the others. Barely functioning, she rarely left the house. Her father, Zinbel, made sure of that. Only occasionally did she venture out on her own, collecting firewood and herbs. Errands out in the Orkney Plains. That was her world. Like this one. Barren and lonely.
Northmen tell of a great hero. His name is Sigurd. His father's hall was built around a great tree, and one day, Odin comes and thrusts a sword into the tree, a gift to whomever can release it. Many try, but the sword only comes out at Sigmund's touch. His brother-in-law, King Siggeir, wants it, but Sigmund refuses him, so King Siggeir plots revenge. He invites Sigmund and his brothers to a feast, but when they arrive, they are met with an army, not a warm welcome. King Siggeir captures Sigmund and his brothers, steals his coveted sword, and readies them for execution.
This emblem on the door. It's not a symbol that I need to match or anything like that. It looks like a sword, perhaps the one they were talking about in this story. Through there. Although this seems to be the main pathway, that makes me think that this may be a secret over here.
Death for Sigmund and his brothers seems certain. But the king's wife is Sigmund's sister, and she begs for mercy and implores the king to chain them up instead. He agrees. Not for mercy, though, but because he plans an even more cruel and lingering death. Chained to a tree in the forest that night, a she-wolf comes and devours one of Sigmund's brothers. She returns, ravenous, night after night, until only Sigmund is left. The next day, Sigmund's sister sends a servant with honey to smear on Sigmund's face. But to what end? Well, that night, when the she-wolf appears again, you'll never guess what happens.
What's your name?
Senua.
I haven't seen you before.
I don't leave home much.
Oh, Zeno's daughter.
I have to go.
Wait. Who taught you to fight like that?
No one.
No one?
Well, I watched you, and...
You... learned all of that from watching me? You should become a warrior, you know.
Me?
I'm Dillian. I'm here for the warrior trials. Just come and watch. And bring your sword.
You can't put it into words. That moment when you look into the eyes of the one who is supposed to reassure you, make you feel safe. It only takes an instant. Fear swallows you before you have a chance to make sense of it. And darkness becomes a part of who you are. But her world changed the day the Northman took him from her. Senua knows that there's no going back to how things were. That there's nothing to go back to at all.
Stay still, stay quiet, hide, don't tell her.
Their gods can see into your mind. They will use this power to destroy you.
They won't stop me. I can still feel him.
Whatever's left of him, they will never let him go.
I'm not gonna let him rot here!
You're the one rotting here.
Leave me alone.
You will die here.
No.
And all your suffering will have been for nothing.
Shut up!
Well, I think I'll end this episode here, and when I return, we're going to go forth to that tree, which from here looks like it has a portal that leads to another realm.